But now the Olympic champion, Chun Meng, will start it off with the serves.
One love.
The backhand spin game safe for Chun Meng to start it off. It'll help there on the opening from the top of the net. Mo Zhang following through with the flatter forehand, stretching out the shoulders, splits the first two serves.
One, two.
Now another thing you'll notice, when anyone has pips on one side of the racket, they typically turn the racket around, they twiddle it, just so they can control the serve with the spin. She'll serve with the red side, Mo Zhang, and then turn the racket around.
3-1.
Chun Meng well in control here. Fans clasp their hands in the front row. 4. Perfectly placed into the middle. You can hear the pialeon from 4. The bench, meaning beautiful from Coach Ma Lin.
Let 4-1.
Attempted flick, but less spin on that forehand side. Could Mo Zhang make that shot? Sure, but the quality has to be just right to cause any trouble for Chun Meng. It's a lot of pressure.
2-5.
Second one on the scoreboard here. Mo Zhang still looking up and cooking up some plans. Careful, but calculated play. Slow spin, remember, when someone plays a top spin motion with these short pips, there's less rotation on it than usual. That's why the ball comes down into the net first. Tough to rally with the short pips. Chun Meng will go backhand to backhand where she can. Sure enough, goes right back to the familiar home sweet home, the inverted rubber on the backhand side.
Left, 6-3.
Mo Zhang has a very elegant style, very delicate touch. But a blast into the elbow on the forehand side. Chun Meng continuing to race ahead. Now, if I had a co-commentator right now, that co-commentator might say, do you think it factors into Chun Meng's mind at all how many Chinese teammates have dropped on the men's side as well?
4-7.
And while the women's team is going to be a little bit closer to home for her, yes, the Chinese team spirit is incredibly strong. They spend a lot of time together, living together in Beijing, training together as a team.
8-4.
It's very much a communal sense out here. It is a Team China. It's not a women's Team China, not a men's Team China. It is Team China is having a rough day. I need to deliver. I need to do what I've done time and time again. Chun Meng up by 4.
9-4.
That said, between Bernie Such twice and Ellie Samara, the women of Romania have thrown their fair share of challenges Chun Meng's way.
4-10.
6 game points to Chun Meng. Da Meng, big dream. Mo Zhang to serve. Into that elbow, side and topspin. Chun Meng dominates in game number 1, 11-4. As Chun Meng cleans the racket there for full traction, it's Mo Zhang to start it off.
One love.
Now the backhand, one secure thing about the backhand, one factor that makes it more consistent, easier to control for Mo Zhang is that she has the spin. And uses it well on the opening, but perfectly in position and ready. Chun Meng on the other side. Flick, recovery so fast. Plays that ball from right near the hip, Chun Meng.
One, two.
When I think of some of the greatest in the game, even into their 40s, let's say Ni Xialian into her 60s, still causing trouble to some of the best in the world.
Two, all.
Timing, placement. Ni Xialian has all sorts of funkiness to her game, but has incredible brain power to be clever enough to think of ways to cause trouble. When you think of the players, Alexis Lebrun on the men's side has the best winning percentage against Chinese opponents. Last I checked, with just over 50%. Style is a big part of that.
Leg. Two, three.
If I were to tell you before Ellie Samara and Bernie Such, non-Asian players that had beaten Chun Meng, you'd be surprised to hear. Beautiful counter, flat hit using the length of the table. At the towel break, I won't keep you in suspense anymore. Amelie Solja of Austria beat Chun Meng. Anti-spin and short pips on each side of a racket. One and one there. Talk about funky styles. Mo Zhang with the change of pace, getting into the rally well here. Covering the middle with the backhand is a key ingredient for taller players. Why? Because it's more efficient. It doesn't get you out of position or leave you exploited on the wide forehand corner. Nice forward clap there in the front row, keeping it out in front for the applause. Mo Zhang does the same quite well typically. Taller players again, using every bit of advantage they can to take the ball early.
Three, four.
But quickly getting just one more point, opening up strong with the spin, Chun Meng. Down by one now. Half long serve, well placed near that baseline.
Four.
I've said this before and I'll say it again. These serves, look at that after motion. So beautiful, very subtle, very fast, still half long. You think about a serve that's not a long serve as not a fast serve. It seems impossible, but the pros find ways to do it. Not too many coaches roar the way Ma Lin does from the coaching bench. Very compact stroke there, Chun Meng keeping that loose grip on the racket until the moment she's decided. With the second towel break here, 2 points in front, Canada's Mo Zhang. Off the top of the net there on the last one.
Five.
Chun Meng dries her hand. Take a look. Just clipping. That extra little bounce changes the trajectory.
Five.
A real turn here. Seven in a row for Chun Meng. She was down 2-5. How you end, have a rough start to your day, you can finish strong. It's a good day. Now it is 5 game points for Chun Meng to take a 2-0 lead. In a game two that started to make you feel like, well, they could be dead even at 3. Game three, that is, but still here in game two, Chun Meng with her second serve. Parallel for the winner, fired up. Unbelievable finish, 9 straight points. Welcome to Saudi Smash. So 3 game points for Chun Meng. On receive here, second serve for Mo Zhang. Oh, the net to finish.
11,
but in
7,
this deja vu moment, it is 2-0 for Chun Meng. Chun Meng back leading 2-0, serving the Mojang of Canada.
Love one.
Good receive for the first point for the Canadian.
1-0.
In case you're curious, of course, people can be born anywhere in the world. It's happening all the time. Mojang, born in China, but has lived in Canada for the majority of his life.
1-2.
Many amazing players in China can only fulfill their dreams living abroad. That's how deep they roll. Even players that you're watching currently, I've had conversations with that have asked me about other places in the world. Feng Tianwei became a world champion for Singapore. And was number 15, give or take, on the national team in China before realizing she just would never get to see her dreams come true if she stayed. Chun Meng, Olympic gold medal is the dream. At the first towel break, she's taken control once again. Long serve deep to that backhand. Out in front for the follow-up, little to no hesitation. And a timeout called. Opponents, but back from the timeout. Mojang starts off quickly with the service point. Don't hear too many expressions of frustration vocalizing from Chun Meng. Beautiful in and out work on this one. Chun Meng leans in, catches that ball from out in front, plays it as if she was perfectly on balance. I like how Mojang holds her ground completely there. Very calm play as the ball comes off the net, says, I'm still in position. Come to me, ball. And a nice deep push. Mojang with the very open racket is able to jab in. A lot of different ways to handle underspin, but if you can turn up the spin, surprise the opponent, can be effective. 1 point game now. A little bit slower one comes in, and Chun Meng perfectly in position once again. Watch where she is, sets up, just like practice. That's what it looks like for Chun Meng in that rally.
Leg. 7-5.
Little look here at points one on serve. Chun Meng almost double the success. Mojang. It just goes to show you how strong Chun Meng's receive is. Players typically have an advantage on serve. Nice coverage of the middle, pulling that right leg back. Mojang finding the slappy forehand from in near the body. Keep your eyes on the right leg here. Has to pull it back to create a little bit of space to get the rib cage turned sideways. Now the farther back behind the table you get with short pips, it's just tough because your flatter shots don't have as good of a view down at the opponent's side of the table. A much needed point for Chun Meng, as Chun Meng had been, well, caught up to before this. It's
nine,
tough.
Seven.
Mojang used the timeout well to get it tied up at 7-all, but quickly Chun Meng in the business end of the game, taking care of just that, the biz.
Mid. 9-7.
Still so much side spin on it. Even the touch after the let carried it off the side of the table. And now it is 3 match points for Chun Meng to move on through to the round of 16. Mojang playing every point as she does. But that is it, the door has been closed. An event over for Mojang in the singles. Chun Meng moves on.